Good morning. We are at Carrollton Cemetery. I've only been here once before, but I have very vivid and pleasant memories of my time here last time. I'm very happy to share this cemetery with you. We do have to be a little bit careful, have our wits about us. It is not uncommon for people to get robbed or hurt in a cemetery. Pretty crazy. There's a tree growing. How is that correct? Earlier in our series, we visited Valence Cemetery in the Ferret neighborhood. Cemeteries that was identified as a neglected area. This cemetery also was identified as one of those. It's had its share of vandalism, crypt robbing. Theft of statuary. So, actually, while I'm here, just in the last few minutes, scent of decay, really strong. So, something is dead in the cemetery. So, it's not very common, but I think this is an instance where a family has owned a crypt, and out of necessity, sold it to another family. Because the Dubois name has been carved out. They are still on the faceplate, but the only one that's really legible is John James Iron. Makes sense. I mean, these things are probably very expensive, costly to maintain. So, I mean, it's like an investment. So if you have the money or need the money, maybe you would sell your crypt. Maybe you're moving out of state. So I have three. Possibly. Incorrect memories of the cemetery. They were probably influenced by first impressions. Fairly new to New Orleans. But as I recall, I remember this cemetery having more statues, like angel statues, than almost any other cemetery I had visited. Looking around now, I don't think that's accurate. That trophy definitely goes to the cemetery. However, second memory. Is, anyway, sorry, I'm listening to a conversation that's happening behind me. My second memory is of grounds that weren't very well maintained, but there were a number of people in the cemetery working on maintaining the grounds. Third memory. Well, in conjunction with that second memory was a large number of crypts that collapsed from the roof and were just hollow shells at that point, with plants and trees growing out of them. Third memory is minutes after my wife and I had left the cemetery, after visiting it for the first time, there was a bolt casing. It is not. There's a battery. both very plausible. Moments after my wife and I had left, after first visiting the cemetery, a family on their porch across the street, not sure which one of these streets, don't remember, were robbed at gunpoint by a group of, they described as teens. So, that has always kind of stuck with me. Probably why I haven't been back. Having just narrowly missed possibly being robbed, or probably having seen those teens and leaving the cemetery. I can't see it because it's so freaking sunny out here. Hopefully I'm picking that up. So yeah, anyway, back to my story. So yeah, that's probably contributed to the fact that I have not been back here. Having just narrowly missed that kind of interaction. Sadly, it's not uncommon in New Orleans. And somehow I have been blessed. And that has not happened to me, or my wife, or my son. So obviously a more modest cemetery, modest incomes. This is the area that is particularly beautiful. It's very similar to Holt Cemetery, which I want to film at some point. tombstones. Very simple burials. In-ground burials, which, you know, is an issue in New Orleans. Warm. Very, very warm. This is a very large area of the very poor. This is the burials that their families could afford. Shade. Yes. A lot of war vets. Sadly have to walk on tombs or on burial plots to get to other burial plots. Sad. Alright, we'll see if we can make our way this way. Try not to get bit by a snake. Fall into a hole. You'd be more than welcomed here. Completely collapsed. See if we can make our way this way. Break granite and marble like that. Almost died. Wildflowers are beautiful. So we were fortunate in that we had a pretty mild spring. Didn't start getting hot until last week, really. Humidity's way up. It is mid-80s right now, but it feels, the humidity is ridiculous. I'm sweating to death. So it is here. This is roughly 1 year anniversary of when all of us started filming the cemeteries. I'm not sure how many I've filmed at this point. Like, individual cemeteries, maybe over a dozen. We filmed in Mississippi. Central Louisiana. That's where it all started, actually. And several in New Orleans. Views are going up. not crazy, not dramatic. It's okay. Again, this is like personally cataloging cemeteries for me. It's not about making money off of YouTube. That is German, for sure. Is this a German community? It is so bright, I can't even tell if I'm recording or not. Some graffiti. That's not sacrilegious at all.